Hello everyone, Aspirin here. Got some new stuff. I went to the swap meet. Got some really cool stuff, like I said. Found this for $10. Finally got myself a Shredder 2003 at the swap meet. And I got this. I have to rebuy it because I have them in the package. And now I got them out of the package. And this was a request. I will do this just for you. believe it or not, I got these turtles, which you're like, oh, I already did those. Yeah, this is 2008, and this is 2008 turtles also. Think about it. And then I got this from eBay, yes. One of the guys who's on my page gave this to me. Thank you very much. The weapon, that is. And now that we're going to, I got some stuff from the Frankenstein. I got Coil Leonardo, he's over there. And I also got Han. I finally found one. And the one we're going to be doing is this. Pandacon. Pandacon, here we go. So this is a review we're going to do on. This is the dark face version. And I already have this one. And we're going to compare them with the white face version. Believe me, people, there's two different kind of Pandacon. So sit back and enjoy this review.
Alright. So yes, I found this at Frankenstein for $10. As you may see, this piece has never been punched in, or punched out, I should say. Pandacon. As you may also see that this one right here is the dark face version, not the white, face. Smash Crane's skull or head, whatever he has in him. So this is the front piece. I thought I have my my other Pandacon. Pandacon, damn. And he has the white face. Like I said, this one right here is the black face. So there's two different kinds. Right there, this is the price. I saw it, I freak out. I was like, yeah, I gotta have this. The bubble is a little bit smashed here and there, but the card is very in good shape. So I had to get it. $10, man. Black face. Been looking everywhere for this one. Alright, so I dig in the closet and I do have it here. Here's a white face, we'll pair with a flutter face. See, white face and dark face. Everything's still the same, as you may see. These things on his legs could easily break off, so be careful for collecting, you don't want anything to break. As you may know, the white face colors are like lighter blue, lighter green. As over here is like darker green and darker blue. So, let me just show you. Where is it? There's his butt. 1990. And that's the guy who made Pandacon, or created Pandacon. But it's still a Playmates toys. So no, Morgan Stewart didn't create Pandacon. He's one of Kevin Eastman's best friends. And no, he's not in a relationship with Usagi Yojimbo. Totally different characters, different stories, and different maker. But once again, I compare his face with the other one. Yes, so that therefore you can see the difference. Mm-hmm. So here's the back part. It has the wacky turtles in the back. And then the good guys. Which, Casey Jones has yellow weapons. Haven't come across that, but he's out there. And the bad guys, which I don't know why Mutant is bad, because in the cartoon he was good, and that's kind of confusing. Oh, and Slash with the purple belt, which I'm still looking and want. And here's the accessories. And of course, it's our favorite, a piece of points. Cut these up, turn them in, you get really cool, like, new accessories or anything they have in their store. Has anyone actually got anything good out of it? Please put on the comments and tell us. See the comic books for Pentacon. Wow, it's actually here in California. Hello, Connor. There's this card. Collector card. Alright. So, he had the white face, you know, that's one of the rare Pentacons, but if you really, really, really want the rare ones, I'll go for the black face. Those are the super rare ones. This is when he's decided to change his color into white. So this is like the classic ones right there. And the very, very, very rare, like I just said. If you're one of those people who want the price, these should be up to like $20-$25. Maybe more now, since this is an old book right here. I'm looking at it. I just made. Like I said, the black face are the rare ones. And I got this for $10, so got it for cheap, and that's why I went for it. The loose ones, if it's white face, it's going to be like around $5. If it's loose and he has black face, it's going to be up to like $8, $10, $20 too. Like I said, if they know what they're selling, they're going to price the dark face up and then give you the cheap ones for this one. But luckily the person didn't know what they're selling, so whoo, look that one out. So, yes, you find the dark face first, get it.
Alright, so that's my little review. If you come to the conclusion that you could only buy one and you see two of these, get the dark face one first, because like I said, this is the most rarest one of all. I recommend getting both. So like I said, they're not made by Morgan Studio, they're made by a different person. And somebody asked me if I do read a script before I do this, and no, this is all coming out of my head. Whatever I see and whatever is coming straight out of my head, I'll have nothing written down, nothing. So could be a headache. So anyways, I recommend getting these. These things are the coolest thing. I love Pentacon. I really do. Tell me your history behind it on yours on the bottom of the comments. Do you have this one? Do you have the life face one? Which one do you have? What's your memory as a child when you have these? So anyways, to end this, go out, find these. Good luck and happy hunting, everyone. See you later.
Alright, so check this out. Here's a dude who's selling it. This guy's selling it, he's actually figures for $60. Shipping is free, will be freaking new, but $60 for Mutation Tonka. You got these two, not the rare ones, and look at his chest is all faded, like the color is gone. So it's not like pink and blue anymore, it's just faded. They don't have any of your weapons, none. And he's selling it for $60. Oh, look at it, you get a bonus for this. Let's see, where is he? Yeah, you get the fast forward Donatello, but remind you, it's supposed to come with the back piece that he shoots out three of his, you know, bow staff, but it's not there, so, ooh, bonus. And I love when people do this. Dude, Tonka, from the second film, like, you don't freaking know, you think you act like you know what you're selling, but they don't use mutation, they use transformer, like, transforms, it's called mutation. This is how you know when somebody doesn't know what they're selling. Look at, frog. Toad? I don't know. But he knows these other ones' names. But I don't know. Is this dude's a fake? He apparently obviously doesn't know what he's selling.